Hello everybody, this is Con. I'm now at Sepang International Circuit attending the launch of the F90 BMW M5 in Malaysia. But before I show you the new car, let's take a stroll down memory lane. BMW Malaysia has managed to source examples of previous generation M5s to show on display. Now there's no unit of the E28 here. The E28 is extremely rare, and I don't think any unit made it to Malaysia. So the displays here start with the E34 M5. This generation was produced from 1988 to 1995. It was powered by a 3.8-liter inline-six engine, making 340 horsepower, 400 newton meters of torque. Of course, this day and age, that kind of output is almost matched by your garden variety 5 Series. In Europe, the G35 Series has the BMW 540i with a 3-liter inline-six turbocharged engine, making 320 horsepower, 400 newton meters of torque. So this M5, this was the flagship version of the 5 Series at that time, with an inline-six making 340 horsepower, 400 newton meters of torque from a 3.8-liter engine. Okay, interesting enough, right, for the E34, they actually have a regular version of the 5 Series with a V8 engine. So back then they had a 530i 3-liter V8, 540i 4-liter V8, and right at the top they go back to the inline 6 with this 3.8-liter BMW M5. Okay, now then in the mid-90s came this baby. This is my favorite car of all time, the E39 BMW M5. So I've always been a big fan of the BMW E39 5 Series, but the M5 really is my ultimate dream car. This will be the car. Okay, if one day, right, I'm kaya raya, money is no object, this is going to be the car that I want to own for myself. Yeah. So, as we all know, right, today in the used car market in Malaysia, the E39 5 Series, the regular versions of the E39 5 Series are relatively affordable, you know, and quite, it's all affordably priced. But the M5s, very, very rare in Malaysia. Yeah, and I think the prices are on a willing buyer, willing seller basis. So they are not likely to come cheap. And being an M car also, these cars are not going to be, cheap to maintain lah. But let me just take a peek of the interior. Now this M5 was powered by a V8 engine producing 400 horsepower, and this was the last M5 to have a proper manual transmission. Check this out. This is a 6-speed manual transmission. Okay, the cabin is the same as you would get in a regular BMW E39. So interesting thing about the E39 is that the side aircon vents, okay, this is a design feature carried over from the E34. The aircon ducts flow, send air from here to here and comes out through the vent that's mounted at the door. Very nice design. And yeah, so let's go on. Over there is the E60. Now interesting enough, BMW Malaysia chose to display a parallel imported Japan spec E60. Now how do you know that this is a Japan spec car? Very simple, look at the number plate. This narrow number plate, when you see a car with a Mercedes, a BM, or any car, right, of these continental cars, luxury cars, with this narrow number plate, right, you know it's a Japan spec car. Yeah, because that's the size of Japanese number plates. Okay, so that's a bit of a trivia for you all. The E60 M5, this is also a very iconic car, powered at that time by a V10 engine, 5-liter V10 naturally aspirated with a 7-speed SMG gearbox. There are many of these in Malaysia. I've seen many units on for sale in Muda, going for up anywhere from 120 right up to 160-170k. So yeah, so it's relatively affordable, yeah, to own one of these. Of course, to maintain, I'm not so sure lah. But yeah, so this is the E60 M5. I'm not that big of a fan of the E60 design, but this is a very iconic car. The 5-liter V10, a thoroughly unique engine, last of its kind. Yeah, so plus the SMG gearbox, we all know it is a very flawed transmission, but at the same time, right, all these characteristics, right, give this car a very unique character that is, you know, you will never get a car like this anymore in the market. Yeah. So here we are. These are the collection of old school BMW M5s. Yeah.